Hi guys, this is another playthrough. This is going to be really brief. I'm just going to show you guys how to get the sword that I was telling you guys about earlier. Okay, so starting from Firelink Shrine, go up here. And you're gonna go this way where the blacksmith is. Oops, I forgot a block. See, I told you they drop battle axes. And you just keep going to reach like the area. This is where the dragon will pop up, but you won't fight him or anything. And I'm just gonna go over here really quick. Missed. Wonder if he's gonna come up here. He is. Okay. And then you're going to use your bow and arrow like I told you guys to get, or I recommended. It'll probably take you more than two arrows. It might take you a little bit more. Alright, after you get rid of them, you can go over here. Just make sure that you be very careful because they can all whoop you pretty easily because you have such a weak weapon. This door right here, you won't be able to open up until you go around. So that's a shortcut later. You'll go through here. Right here you could go through, just be careful. You can explore all this stuff on your own, but you just want to make sure that nobody creeps up behind you. You'll go up here. You can go up here, up that ladder. Just make sure no one follows you. This drawer here where the chest is out here, this is the key that you buy from the merchant that's very close by. So you want to make sure you get that key in order to get what's in the chest. You want to go up here and up the stairs before you go any further because there's this guy. And of course he's overlooking the path where you need to go, and if you don't get rid of him, he might get you in the back. Right here you can lure him out one after the other, but I'm just gonna show you really quick. Down here, all the way down, is where one of those big guys are. He'll be in that doorway down there. There's an item back there, but what I suggest in getting rid of him would you can get him from behind and then run away or try making a lot of noise and then running back up the stairs. You can run all the way back up, he'll follow you. You can run all the way back up these stairs, and then you can go up that ladder, and he won't go up the ladder. So he'll go down these stairs and he'll just be waiting. So when he goes down these stairs, that's when you can just like book it and run for the item. And a lot of the times he doesn't follow after you because he doesn't know that you left from that area. When you go up these stairs, you want to be very careful because there's another guy with a barrel. Or a boulder. I forgot what it was. It's been a while since I've been up here, but there will be a guy up here. When you're starting off early, I'm pretty sure you need the master key for this door. But when you start off early, you want to be very careful because all the way down is a guy that's wearing Havel's armor, and this is what Havel's armor looks like. It's very huge and very thick, and he's also slow, but he's very strong, so you want to be really careful that you want to be. Oh, I don't have the mask, but this is basically what his armor looks like. He has a huge shield too. Let me show you the shield. It's pretty badass, but it's heavy. Here it is. This is a shield, and you need like 50 strength to wield it. That's what I have right now. I have 50. I just barely got it. Oh yeah. Usually I use the Gravelord sword and the pyromancy. I use my bow and I use my Black Knight shield because it's good with fire. And I use my Black Knight armor and my gold-hemmed black cloak a lot. But you're gonna go up these stairs. This is where the second boss is. As soon as you enter through here, there's guys up here. So as soon as you go through the doorway, the fog, you won't see the boss right away. So you'll kill them. Once you go halfway across the bridge, the boss will come running after you. When he does that, turn around and run for this ladder. As soon as you get up the ladder, go up here and then do a downward attack on its head. And you just keep doing that. Once you get down here, just like go through between his legs, run through. I usually go like halfway point. I wait till he does a jumping attack, and then when he stands back upright, I run through his legs and then go back up the ladder and repeat the process. You can also make him fall like around here, but I don't risk it because I don't want to fall. So once you're done with him, you come through here go down here. And that doorway across there will be locked. You get it through another way, but as soon as you like step around here, there's a big dragon. The dragon's not right there, but the dragon will come and like set everything on fire, so you'll have to run back this way really fast. There's a guy over here that gives you this, the white sign soapstone. Solaire of Astora, but you want to be careful over here because this is where the dragon pops up like that. Oh. Boom. Okay. Here, I'll use this. But when you're running through here, you wanna hug the wall right here, or on the other side, you just wanna hug the wall. You wanna hug the right side because there's a staircase. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Okay. So you want to go through the staircase on the bottom. Now down here, when you first go through here, don't be afraid about the dragon. Because if you do die from the flames, you can always come back and the second boss that you got, it won't be there anymore. This guy, he's a pain in the ass. But as soon as you come down the stairs, there's going to be two doors. There's going to be one to your right and the one to your top. So you want to go to the one at the top, go down the stairs. There's a ladder, and this is the ladder that goes down into the bonfire. So this is a really quick shortcut. So all you do is it'll say kick the ladder or whatever. You go down the ladder and you can re-up your Estus flask, come back up here, and then you'll have the dragon right there. But as soon as you come down, you're gonna go to the right. You're gonna equip your bow and make sure you equip your arrows. You're gonna come to the right side over here, and you see where his tail's hanging off. You're gonna equip your bow and arrow, and you're gonna keep shooting at his tail. You're gonna be shooting not really high up, but like around here, this area. You're gonna be shooting at it. I'm a really horrible shot, but there. So he'll come this way. He won't knock you off or anything. So basically, you keep doing this for a while. You keep doing it for like, I'd say 15 to at least 30 times. I don't really remember how long. I just kept shooting him and shooting him until I got it. But as soon as you do it enough times, it'll pop up directly on your screen and saying that you got an item. And it's, where is it? It's down here. Oh my gosh, I don't have it equipped with me. Here, I'll show you guys what it is. I don't have it right now because I used this sword, and this sword is badass. But you can get this sword a lot later when you meet the Gravelord Nito and you like join his covenant. Right here. This is it. you get the Drake Sword. The Drake Sword is a little over 200, I believe, or 200. You need 16 strength to wield it and 10 dexterity to wield it. It weighs 6 pounds and it's pretty high on the durability. Its physical strength is a lot and its critical is a lot, so it's a really good sword. It doesn't seem a lot like now, but when you first get it, it's going to be really hard to see how fast it's going, like compared to other stuff that I have. This is practically how it's going to be when you swing it. When you first get the Drake Sword, that's about how much it's going to weigh. So, yeah, good luck to you. Hope you guys get it. Get past the dragon, at least on your first time. I'll keep going with these videos. If you'd like to see more, just let me know. Good luck on the game. Thanks for watching.